everybody out there. I'd like you to welcome to a Magic TV Extra. I'm Tristan Shaun Gregson here with Luis Scott-Vargas.
I'm not doing the little X thing.
That's fine. I'm down with it. You're not a WWF fan from the mid-90s?
No.
We're already way off topic. Talking about such things. What's it like to be on a team, Luis?
That's a question sent in by Merle from New Zealand, asking what are the benefits of being on a team as opposed to just, you know, kind of playing individually. I think that calling it a team makes it sound a little more formal than it really needs to be. For the most part, when I think team, I just think a group of friends, and I think that's really important. Having friends who you like to play test with, who you share cards with, who you go to with to tournaments, that's really important. I think that's what kept me in Magic for much of the time.
Yeah, I feel the same way. I think team is a very formalized, almost like the last stop on the road to playing Magic.
I think if you go out looking, I need to join a team to get better. I think you're looking at it the wrong way. I think what's more important is finding friends who enjoy playing Magic and then working towards that goal.
The nice thing is organically that happens within the game. I remember
exactly.
It's a long time ago. It started with me wanting to play the game. Then it was like me and my roommate were playing the game. It's like the two of us wanted to find other people to play with.
Well, like in college, I started going to this card store after I moved to a new town, and I ended up living with a couple of guys the next year who I met there, and we all played Magic, and we all wanted to play in PTQs, so we, you know, practiced online and, you know, tested against each other, and there we, you know, that created our team, even though we never really thought of ourselves as a team, really. But there are some definite, like, tangible benefits. One is sharing collections. It's pretty hard, especially for, like, Extended, to have access to everything, you know, Dark Depths, Dual Lands, Fetch Lands. But if you've got a team and a group of three or four people or more who all have cards to contribute, you can probably build everyone a deck. It might not all be the same deck, but you still have access to every deck.
That's one thing I like about the groups I used to play with. There's a lot of diversity in what we liked. So we're able to...
Yeah, I mean, if someone always wants to play Zoo and you never want to play Zoo, that's fine. You don't mind lending them, you know, your Ranger of Eos or Knight of the Reliquary.
Your Stomping Grounds.
Yeah, exactly.
You own, you want to have.
Whereas, you know, you're looking to borrow Chrome Moxes, Sunken Ruins, and Dark Depths, and they don't want to play those. So I think lending cards is a really big deal. The other is just having people to root for at tournaments. If, let's say, you went to a PTQ by yourself and you started 1-2, well, at that point you drop and you go home, and your day probably wasn't that fun.
You're already pretty disinterested and over it.
But imagine if you went 1-2, but your two teammates were, you know, 3-0, 4-0, 5-0, made top 8, whatever. It's pretty fun to sit there and, you know, cheer them on, also scout for them, which is another benefit I'll get to. Just having basically a combined effort. Like, I remember we always used to share the prizes we got at PTQs. So even if one of us didn't do well, but another person, you know, made top 8 and won a box, you know, everyone would get something to show for it.
Mm-hmm.
Going back to scouting, if, let's say, you get paired against someone, but your teammates already played them, that, you know, before the round starts, and that you can't, obviously, when they're, like, about to sit down and play, you can't. But before the round starts, yeah, you can definitely let them know what they're playing, what they might sideboard, et cetera. And that, you know, definitely helps.
Definitely advantages to having that group or that team.
Like, I remember at a PTQ, one of my friends was playing, and he played against a guy who I knew had Shrapnel Blast and Barb Lightning. It was a Mirrodin Block Limited. So my friend chose to Essence Drain his opponent's face to gain 3 life when his opponent was at, like, 15 and he was at, like, 10. His opponent was going to kill him next turn with burn spells. And he wouldn't have done that if he didn't know about them. So he ended up making top 8 at that PTQ.
Now, I mean, do you really think that a group or a team has allowed you to get the level you were at, or just been a benefit of wanting to play more Magic and being competitive at it?
I think it's both. I think it definitely helps because, you know, if you and your friends are playtesting certain matchups, you're going to advance all your knowledge about those matchups. And if someone's better at one thing, eventually that'll rub off on everyone else and they'll get better at that. And everyone has different strengths, you know, usually. So I think, especially if you have a lot of teams have people different skill levels, a rising tide lifts all ships. It'll help everyone get better.
Yeah, it's nice to have a larger pool again. Like, when I first started playing competitively, it was, for the most part, it was my roommate and I. I mean, we would sit at our apartment, we'd have a gauntlet of decks, and we could play theoretically all the matchups of a particular format.
Right.
But widening that pool and playing against other players who had other experiences really helped us out. It was like, oh, I hadn't thought about running that card, or I hadn't considered this deck, or just how to play this scenario.
And, you know, as you get more organized, you can do more stuff like that too. Like, again, I never was in a really formal team, but some people do like doing stuff like that, and they like, you know, creating websites or forums for their team, or getting all the same shirts, you know. And that's a way to show solidarity, and it's a way to organize your team. Like, if you have enough people on a team, you can say, hey, why don't you two practice this matchup, and we'll practice this matchup, and we'll report our findings. Especially a lot of teams that aren't near each other geographically, and they communicate online. And that works out pretty well. I mean, that's what playtest groups look like for the Pro Tour. It's, there's no reason that you can't build your own. So I think in general, Magic is a group effort. And if you play it by yourself, you're going to get a lot less rewards. Both just, you know, socially, it's a lot less fun. And you're going to not do as well in tournaments as if you had a good support system. So to answer Merle's question, teams offer a ton of benefits. And I would definitely recommend, you know, just trying to find other people who like doing what you do. That's just reinforcing in its general nature. You don't need to, like, you know, have the mindset of I need to find a professional team, because that doesn't really happen. So
yeah, they happen organically from my experience.
That's in general what happens. So.
Yeah. People that like to play would like to play more and would like to play more. And that's how just kind of how it goes.
Plus, another benefit is Merle now has $25 store credit.
Hey-o! So. Congratulations again to Merle. And a reminder to everyone out there again to send in all your submissions for ideas for Magic TV to magictv@channelfireball.com.
Exactly. And we'll have another, you know, good topic next week, hopefully.
Exciting.
Thanks for watching.